What's up, guys? Zeenigami here. The global version has 2x skill ups. We also have all the fun stuff like our 5 plus Luffy, or Super Evolution Luffy, and Super Evolution Zoro. I would recommend you go through, if you're at the 3-day 2-year story mode island, is to actually play through 3-day 2-year story mode at least until you get to stage 7-8, I think, are the ones with Zoro and Nami's skull, to see if you happen to get Zoro or Nami's skull on your first playthrough. And then pick whichever one you don't get if you don't. Otherwise, Zoro would be my recommendation between the Nami and the Zoro skulls. So, actually, before we do super success, let's sell some crap. Oh, there's training points. There's a training points filter. But, I'm too lazy to do that. Let's just go down, I've got tons of space to be made. 1, 2, 3, 4. Buy Gear 3 Luffy. Bum. Yes. Yeah, it's Evolve. I don't know how you wouldn't figure out that Super Evolution is an evolution, but some people on Facebook have managed to power up using their skulls instead of evolving. To which case, my reaction is... Good job. So, yeah, sometimes I don't say things because it seems like the words Super Evolution might tip you off that you want to evolve a Super Evolution, but, you know, that's my fault for assuming. I shouldn't assume people knew that. My bad. Receive! Get rid of all this stuff. And then once again, I was looking around, you could technically farm for Rayleigh points by doing stuff like farming raid bosses. But, you know, with how much stamina it takes to farm a raid boss for 10 points per 60 stamina raid boss, if you buy 5 gems and then buy a rare recruit and just get a 100 gem rare recruit, 100 training point rare recruit, that's a better use of your time than farming a raid boss to sell for Rayleigh points. No, that's story mode. These guys are worth Rayleigh points. These gals. Training points. Rayleigh points, training points. Rayleigh shot, Rayleigh bizarre. Invasion Whitebeard. Whatever you want to call them. So we have Invasion, Whitebeard, and Raid Boss Akainu coming soon. Or... not Invasion, but... Ambush Quest, Whitebeard, and... Akainu Clash coming soon. My recommendations for most players on Global for how to beat the Ambush Quest Whitebeard and the... Akainu raids are going to be good luck, and that's it. The estimated level for your recommended level for the Akainu raid is going to be level 250. There are free to play teams that you can use it. But they are still very difficult to beat, especially stage 3. So there's several things about the... I don't know why I'm stopping there. There's several things about the Akainu raid that makes it quite difficult. For one... not these guys. For one, you can't heal during the raid, because on stage 2, you're going to get the anti-healing debuff. And that means you can't heal at all. No heal per turn, no... recovery orbs, no specials that heal, so you can't use Marco special or any specials that heal. None of those work. You also are going to get your captain swapped on stage 3. So you can't zombie it. You could zombie and revive, technically. Except Akainu also does end of turn damage, so you can't zombie him anyways. You could Shiryu. So there is a Shiryu strategy. You could use Shiryu. But remember that Akainu does revive, so if you use Shiryu, you have to have your Shiryu work twice. So you can't use one Shiryu, you have to use two Shiryus to actually kill the Akainu raid. But I will make a preparation guide for a Gainu raid that will be up on YouTube. But honestly, most people are not going to be able to beat it, and don't feel bad if you can't beat it. Most of you are just not going to be able to beat the Gainu, and most people are not going to beat Young Whitebeard. I mean, even on the Japanese version, my Gainu raid is got like terrible skill ups, and my Invasion Whitebeard or Ambush Quest Whitebeard has terrible levels. But to be honest, the Invasion Gainu or Ambush Quest Gainu isn't too important. He's a great orb, like he's amazing, but he's not so important that you need him. You can get around with not using him with a lot of this stuff. If you do have him, he's gonna be amazing in whatever team you throw him in. But not super vital. At least not yet. Oh yeah, give me those points. Oh, actually, I still have 6-star characters I haven't unfavorited yet. A zombie team. Yes, you can zombie through Young Whitebeard. So the problem with zombieing Young Whitebeard is that the chance that Young Whitebeard shows up is pretty low. Here's the estimated chance for a Young Whitebeard to show up is about 20% on a 60 stamina fight. Might be about 10%. Somewhere it's around 10 or 20% on a 60 stamina fight and around 5% on a 40 stamina fight. So if you're going to use a zombie team on like a 40 stamina fight, that's, you know, 1 out of 20 times about. And if you're going to do a 60 stamina fight, you know, it's maybe 1 out of 10, maybe 1 out of 5 to actually get that to show up. And then you can zombie through. So you can definitely zombie team to get Young Whitebeard, but it's the hardest part is just getting Young Whitebeard to show up. That will take a while. I sold Shiryu? I did. So we got him already. Oh, and let's unfavorite you. Just a few more characters for the Rayleigh points. Unfavorite you. My recommendations for what to buy with Rayleigh points are going to be buy ships, first of all. Ships are the best thing to buy with those training points. ASAP, get those ships. Any of the ships are good. The characters are a bit of a hit and miss. But all the ships on the Rayleigh shop are really good. Really bizarre. Whatever, forget my words. Does Timeskip Luffy work with Gainu? Timeskip Luffy basically beats everything. If you have the right subs for Timeskip Luffy, you can basically beat everything. This is not so much do you have Timeskip Luffy as do you have the subs to support Timeskip Luffy. That's the hard part about Timeskip Luffy, just having the subs to support it. I'm not going to worry about six-star Hancock and six-star Hancock Plus. Bye! We'll just pull another one in the Seagull Fest. Don't worry about it. And now we can do skill-ups. Oh, Int Mihawk. Heck yeah! Ba-da-ba-da. Ba-da-ba-da-ba-da. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here we go! Global skill-up rates! Everyone's favorite global skill-up rates, man. Yeah, no, I only had 4 Duke Legends on global. Ah! Fuck you, fuck you, Global. God, fuck you, Global. One. Oh, fuck you, Global. Yay! Global's skill up rates are the best. Don't you just love that? Don't you just love that, man? It's not like Int Mihawk's a good character anyways. I mean, Int Mihawk is like the worst. I didn't want to use Int Mihawk anyways. It's just terrible. What a butt face. Wow, nice. Oh, good. Oh, what are we doing? What are we doing? Skill ups? Hello? Where are my skill ups, man? I thought I'm sorry, I thought this was America. This is America. That's why it's happening. Damn it, America. You use 35 Int Mihawk specials and you still have level 2. Ouch. It's okay. At least my Alvita will get some, maybe? Oh, dude. Oh, dang it, girl. You're done. Alright, Alvita. Alvita. Before we do Alvita skill books, let's just do regular Alvitas. Let's see what we get. Because if we max out her levels here, then we only use her skill books. We can save her skill books for another time. One. You're wondering on Japan, is there an item to remove cotton? No, you can't remove cotton candy. Honestly, don't worry about it though. Like, if you're worried about what your cotton candy is, don't. It's not that important. You're not going to ever have a team with 200 cotton candies on a character. I mean, some people do, but you probably don't. The people who have six 200 cotton candy characters on their team are the people who are like, well, since I've already farmed everything, I might as well just go farm for multiple copies of this story mode character in order to get skill ups on that story mode character. Bind. Ooh! Nice. And that's how I decide my sockets on characters. People always ask me, what sockets do I get on a character? Just whatever's convenient. What's cotton candy do? Cotton candy gives you additional stats on a character. So that way you can raise your character stats above their max. More damage reduction, more heal per turn. Easy pickings. Still got tons of Alvitas. Come on, Alvita. Be nice to me, girl. Da-da-da. Ba-da-da-ba-ba-bum. Triggered. It's alright, man. What's important is that we got the poison sockets on our Magellan. That's what's really important. Ba-da, ba-da-da-da. Do-do, do-do-do-do. Six. Come on, 7. I want those Japan rates. I want 2 out of 5, please. Have I gotten a decent amount of the all stat, the yellow cotton candies? You've never actually gotten one? They show up every once in a while. They're not, like, super common. They're rare cotton candies, but... you know, whatever you get. I usually slap those on any character I want recovery on. So I just treat the yellow cotton candy as a recovery cotton candy anyways. Despair, max heal. Thank you. Can I recommend a starter team you just started playing? Well, first of all, welcome to One Piece Terror Cruise. My recommended starter team is whatever you like. Don't worry about it too much. All you have to worry about are look at the characters, anything that says like boosting attack damage. You want to use those as your captains, and then use characters that work with that captain. Like, if you have a captain that says boost slasher attack damage, then use slashers. If you have something that says boost fighter attack damage, use fighters. A great starter captain is your Luffy. You can turn that Luffy into the Super 5 Plus Luffy, and then use whatever you want with him since he works with every character. Jazzy and Martel! Sorry for speaking ill of the Celestial Dragons. You forgot they're gods among us. Don't ban you. It's okay. Woo! Nice! Max Alvita. Clutch Max the Alvita special. Nice. Jazzy Martel, I forgive you, but I'm not the one who you should be apologizing to. You should be apologizing to the Celestial Dragons, man. They're the ones who you might have slighted. It's okay, you know. I understand. Did we start Resident Evil 7? No, we have not started Resident Evil 7. The next one we're going to be starting is Firewatch. We're probably going to start Firewatch later tonight. Yes, consider, if you're starting out in One Piece Treasure Cruise, consider deleting your account and starting a new one with a 6-star character on it. So that's like restarting. Oh yeah, they're the same skill ups. Forgot. Consider starting over with a brand new account during a Sugalfest, because during a Sugalfest you can get 6-star characters, and those 6-star characters are very, very, very strong. If you have any of them, you can use those, take them away. Have fun with them. You can also go to reddit.com/r/onepiecetc, and a lot of people have account giveaways on there. Because it's a lot easier to start off with a good account and then make it even better than it is to have a okay account and try to get those rare characters on him. Ba-da-da-da-da. 2 skill ups. Hell yeah, Caesar. Caesar, toss my salad, please. Yep. A Gainu raid means you have 0 healing after stage 2. So Enel Captain is useless after stage 2. So if you're doing the cabbage team, it's better to do 5 plus Luffy cabbage than Enel cabbage, because Enel cabbage only helps out for stage 1. Man, we're getting some good skill ups onto Caesar. Thank you, Caesar, and please toss my salad. Ba-da. It'll channel get 0 skill ups. Well, thanks for saving the skills for me, bro. Pika and Nightmare Luffy a myth on Global? Yep, they just wanna watch Global get Shrek'd by Gainu. Luffy is very, very, very good. Is he worth a 5 million experience me? You know, honestly, if you're starting out and you don't have a 6-star character, you could. You can give him a meet. Just because he's basically like the best free-to-play captain you'll use. Ever, basically. So honestly, just because if you're a new player, you probably don't have many turtles, and you're going to be using him as your captain for almost forever. Yeah, I actually would say it's not a bad idea. But if you have 6-star characters, of course, just use it on 6-star characters. But most people don't have that luxury. And Global's been throwing around meats like it's nobody's business. I haven't evolved you. I'm gonna wait. I'm gonna wait to get a Pingu Wingy. Do-do-do-do-do. Monet. Na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na-na. Did I finish my placements? I have not. I think, on 8 out of 9 games on League for placements. We will be streaming League more on Twitch, though. What was I farming when the Whitebeard Island came out? I barely got Mihawk and Caesar books. I don't remember. Colosseum, probably. Frolligary Desu took a nap so you could watch the stream, but now you just feel worse. You hate naps. Aww. How long was your nap? If you take a nap, you should... Oh, man, good skill ups. Whoo, good skill ups. Oh, welcome to Japan. If you take a nap, try to take a nap for, like... No, don't take, like, a super long nap, because when you sleep for too long, your body just wants to go to sleep forever. I say that, but I also love like really long naps. So I love just having myself a nice long nap so I feel like shit when I wake up. Max 1 Monet. 4-hour nap. Yeah, at that point you basically went to sleep. You guys want to have some fun, look up an Iron Man sleeping schedule. I had a friend who was doing an Iron Man sleeping schedule. That's... You sleep for like... You take like multiple 30 minute to like an hour sleeps a day, but you have like a very, very strict sleep schedule. Like, you're gonna sleep for... You're gonna sleep, like, four times for an hour each, and then wake up each time over during the course of a day. So you, instead of sleeping for, like, 8 hours, you're only sleeping for 4 hours. But you're sleeping, like, I'm gonna sleep at 8 a.m., then noon, then 4 p.m., then 9 p.m. And you're gonna do that every day, so you get, like, more hours, but you have weird sleeping hours. It's an interesting experiment. You basically put your body into a state where you fall asleep on time every time, and then your body like just jumps straight to REM sleep because you're like on that weird schedule. It's interesting. I think it's called the Iron Man sleeping schedule. No, I like my sleeps. Past 4 hours, you can't even call it a nap anymore, but at 4 hours, great nap. When do we get Sanji, Usopp, and Chopper 5 Plus? Well, seeing as I don't have the ability to see the future, I don't know. Soonish? You would have gone to bed, but you don't want to miss the stream? Dude, go to bed, man! I'm sorry I'm messing up your sleep schedule. My sleep schedule is already messed up, and I want to mess up other people's too. Who did I just pick? Ace. Ace. Did I even save a Colosseum Ace? I did not. I turned all my Ace into skill up books. Who's the best orb booster for a Jinbei fighting team? Marco. 6-star Marco. Go get yourself a 6-star Marco. Just go pick up a 6-star Marco, man. Ba-ba-ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-ba-ba. 19 bucks, 0 skill ups. Nice. You slept for 10 hours today? Feels good, man. One skill up for one Giola. That's just peachy. Did I have a Frankie saved or not? Did I get rid of my Frankies? I think I might have... Yeah, I have one Frankie saved. The rest I turned into stronger Frankie sockets. You woke up at 2:30 last night after an all-nighter. Oh, man, dude. My sleep schedule's all sorts of messed up. Who doesn't love that Giola, man? Extra Giola rate? The best! Honestly, you have Giola, you can just sell it. You don't have to worry about keeping a Giola around in case she becomes useful. Giola is never useful. I don't have you. Did I do a video on Marineford Part 2 story mode? If it's not on YouTube, I don't think I have one. But what am I doing, another 24-hour stream? I don't know what our next... I guess our next, like, big event would be 40,000 YouTube subs, which we're getting pretty close to. I don't know. Give Giola for free for 2 years. How's Giola never useful? She can be great on a driven team to reduce high damage. I mean, using a Vankov would be better. The problem with Giola is... Using a Vankov is better. I mean, if we're going to go into the everybody's useful, if you use it with a little bit of imagination, yeah, Giola's useful, but is Giola worth keeping if you don't have Inazuma? I guess. Where is my Sanji? There you are. What team would I advise for Osiris Plaza Chapter 7? Just use whatever team you use for Chapter 6. Do do do. Ba da 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 da. Ba da ba da. Can you use Strong Ace to kill a Gainy raid? Maybe. I wouldn't recommend it, though. We are going to have a preparation guide for a Gainyue raid out later. the preparation that you should be doing is preparing to lose. Is the preparation that most people should be doing for a kind of new raid is preparing to lose. Preparing to lose bad, too. Like, preparing to not even make it far, but just lose bad, bad, bad. Is that the right? Yeah, that's the right Nami. Can Hancock kill a Gainu? No. I'm just gonna say no. We're gonna have a preparation guy. Oh, hey, look, Max Phillips. But you're going to prepare to lose. You're gonna prepare to lose bad. Oh, Chopper, you're done! Robin that I'll never use because every other Robin is better than you. It's a shame that you're Robin because you might have been useful if you weren't Robin. Since Global is catching up with Japan, do I think they'll be on the same pace and release content together? Never. Makes sense, the second anniversary of Google has characters at their skill books. Are you saying it makes sense, like, who is on there because their Fortnite's out? I guess. I mean, that's what they say it's gonna be. Double an L? Go watch my Gainu walkthrough video on YouTube. We just got 4 skill ups out of 5? Jesus. Why? Why? Oh man, what a waste of skill ups. Waste of skill ups on a Robin I'm pretty much never gonna use because every other Robin's better. Is it possible to do this versus a Gainu? Is it possible to do that versus a Gainu? If you would like an answer now, you can donate some money. I'll be happy to give you an answer now. Otherwise, wait for my walkthrough video and my preparation guide. It'll answer all of your questions, and also, if you have to ask questions, you're not going to beat a Gainu. Let's get something straight. If you have to ask questions about how to beat a Gainu, you're not going to beat a Gainu. It's not something you do. You're just not. You're going to lose. You can also spend a lot of money to get a Gainu. That's always an option that plenty of people will take. And then I'll look at them and go, why? Why'd you do that? Why'd you gem 16 times for a Gainu? Because you shouldn't. You should not gem 16 times for a Gainu. You should not gem 10 times for a Gainu. You should not gem 5 times for a Gainu. Just don't get a Gainu, man. Just don't. Don't. I have my Raid Boss at Gainu on Japan. I have never used my Raid Boss at Gainu on Japan. I've never actually used Raid Boss at Gainu on a team on Japan. Mostly because of skill ups. I have like 3 skill ups on him. Bum, 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 ba-da, ba-da. And we have 6 star Gainu, so you know it is that thing. Is Log Luffy good against a Gainu? Like I said, I'm not gonna give you any answers. A Gainu is still good with a 6-star Gainu. They go great together. Who doesn't love not getting any skill-ups on my Luffy? You can't use 2 Gainus on team. Yeah, but you wanna get the highest damage ever! One a Gainu, one Log Luffy team for the win! Wow, it's okay, at least it was a shitty Luffy anyways. At least you were a shit Luffy, man. As if I wanted to use Luffy anyways. Alright, let's get 1 skill up on Usopp. Let me get my second Golden Hunt Usopp maxed out. Yes? Yes? That was 0 for 14. Dunzos! Dunzos. It's okay, I'm never using that Luffy anyways, so I'm fine with getting 0 skill ups on the Luffy. It's not a Luffy I'm using. I have a Foxy. Where are you, Foxy, you terrible, terrible character who I absolutely despise because you made Chopper cry? Do I have him on Japan? I have him on Japan, I guess. Double Yule against Akainu? Akainu will cry for using... Just because he's a team that's so good, Double Giola. Truly, that is a team that deserves a whole lot of memes. You gave 20 skill books without a skill up. Welcome to Global. Hi, welcome to Global. Did you like farming those skill books? Well, congratulations. You gotta farm a lot more. I have this Frankie, don't I? Yeah, we do. Yeah, we do. You always forget this is a stream, well, what else would it be? This is pre-recorded. Which will be true later. That will actually be true whenever this pops up on YouTube. Ba-da-ba-da-ba-da-da-ba-da-da-da. Do we know when? Well, Manny, if it's not announced. Leosercal! I think I'll stare at Akainu and do nothing! I'd rather not get a flaming magma fist up your ass! You won't judge if people do. I mean, like people, you might have a fair chance against, like, one of the lower difficulties. But the recommended team level, I think, is 250, which I wouldn't argue too much about. Pirate level 250, I think, is a recommended level for raid boss Akainu. I should unfavorite and sell that Bellemere. Those Mihawks are saved for Blue Mihawk, who I hope to get maybe one day. Would be nice. Oh, it's only 60 ammo. I knew that. Get fucked. Global, get fucked. Good luck, Global. Just use that raid boss Sabu of yours. He's gonna go great. Maybe a Pika would be nice. Nightmare Luffy to help you get through some of your older stages. Some of those characters would be nice. Yep. Good stuff. If you use a 6-star Blackbeard, he's quite good. Nothing like that 6-star Blackbeard to help you out. Oh wait, Blackbeard. I meant to say 6-star Akainu. Use that 6-star Akainu, he'll help you out. Or the 6-star Buggy. Oh, the Buggy? So that way you can fight one Akainu and get 3 Akainus with that 6-star Buggy, Captain. You Brooks. Get Brooked. I kinda wanna save Brook for time skip Brook. What was your special, Brook? Heals for 3 turns. Yeah, you know what? No, we're saving Brooks in case I get a time skip Brook, because Brooks are worthless. I don't care. Brooks are worthless. Bun, 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 bun. What's up, Elegant Saria? How are you doing? Those are some lovely emotes. Oh, you're maxed. Why didn't I just give you earlier? I didn't realize my smoker was max. How's this smoker? Also max. Are you ready to get? You ready to see 1 out of 1 bind sockets? 1 out of 1 of bind sockets. One out of one. We have a 1 in 8, which is just like global skill ups. Oh, bam! Got it. Better than global skill up rates. Oh, hacks confirmed. Got him, coach. Got him. Here goes my Sugo luck. Yeah, it's gonna be. Oh, hey, look, 1 out of 1 skill ups, all the best. And maxed out. We're done with the green general zombie, the best of the general zombies. Are you not worth points? Oh, Schnauzel. You're not worth points, are you? Oh, dang it, you're farmable. Oh, snap, I forgot. Well, I mean, you're not worthless. You got a quick, short cooldown special, I guess, I suppose. Sockets ahoy! Maybe I should save him for the Coliseum, Miss Valentine's, who isn't bad, but I'm not going to save her for 9 months for Coliseum Valentine's. Bum bum bum. Do do do. Do do do. Do 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 do. Bum bum ba da da. Okay. Kizaru time. You are going to be very useful against Akainu. Please give me that luck so I can use you against Akainu. I would really, really like it if I got to use you against Akainu. That'd be really, really helpful. Really, really helpful. Should have farmed more. Should have gone hardcore. One. Oof. Wow. What a set of choices. Okay. Let's go. 1 out of 5. She's 88% damage reduction after a certain point. Which is what's the threshold that that you have to get to first with her? I don't remember off the top of my head. Are you Well, looks like someone's about to get resilient sockets on them. Come on, baby. Come on, give me those skill ups. Oh, 1 out of 15. Whew! I've gotten 4 poison sockets now. You're not making this very easy for me, Kizaru. We're not having a good Kizaru day. Really would like to use you against the Kainu raid. 1. What? Great. Wow. Okay. Okay. That's just peachy. Well, I mean, like, maybe we won't die with our thanks to our resilience sockets. Good stuff. Hey, there's one. Oh, you hurt me. Ah, heal. Okay, there we go. Swap the hell over fast. Yeah, you're not gonna be looking good against the raid boss Akainu. Not looking good at all. Give me like, 2 skill ups? No skill ups. Yeah, me and free to play versus a guy who's not looking good. I don't know if I'm gonna be able to free to play versus a guy new like this. I might just have to tell people about how to free to play versus a guy new, and not. Oh, I too. More heal return, thank you. We got 5 whole skill ups. Really going great. I don't even want to know what cooldown that is right now. Even if we got every single skill up from now on, we can't max them out. So that's good stuff. Yep, nope. Oh, shit. Hmm. Alright. Free-to-play versus a guy who is... I think is dead. I think it might be dead. The teams I want to use are 5 plus Luffy. It's Kizaru is on a team. Yeah, 5 plus Luffy, Cabbage, Kizaru, Rob Lucci, Dofi, and Aokiji, I think, is a team off the top of my head. The team I want to use. Oh no, I don't need Kizaru on it. Well, at least I don't need Kizaru on that team. What about this one? We're using Kizaru on the Enel Cabbage team. And we're using Kizaru on the Enel Kizaru team. I mean, Kizaru on the Enel Aokiji team. Hmm. So, Kizaru, you're ending at 18 turns. That'll be okay. That'll be okay. That'll be doable. Should be doable. Could be a lot better, but doable. Still not gonna be a good. Still not gonna be a good time. But doable. Should be okay. I should be able to use them. What are we doing free to play? Well, I'll be trying to. Cabbage is Cavendish. Yes. My cabbages. What's up, Arm Santoru? How you doing? No skill-ups, because I never want skill-ups anyways. Who needs skill-ups? Skill-ups are for losers. I need to move my sockets around. I don't want sockets like that. Heal per turn! Despair! Thank you! There we go. I didn't get any skills, my Momonga. Thanks, Global. I love Global. My favorite part about Global is how there's never nothing to do on Global. Because if you want to get skill ups, you gotta farm for a ton of them. To be fair, my sockets aren't done on my Momonga either, so. Aokiji, you got your for the Aokiji team to use a friend 6-star Aokiji. It's a friend 6-star Aokiji. So it's friend 6-star Aokiji, 5 plus Luffy, friend 6-star Aokiji, Enel, and friend 6-star Cabbage Gear 5 / friend 6-star Cabbage Enel. If I don't have Kizaru Max, Gladius works. Yeah, but Gladius isn't free to play. Like, I need him to make free to play guides. Like, I have plenty of teams I can use to beat him myself, but to make guides for people is the part I'm having trouble with. Because I can beat a Gainu. I don't doubt I can beat a Gainu relatively consistently. Even my consistent team is gonna be probably only like 2/3 of the time I'm beating him. Maybe 3/4 at best. But even my oh wow, Brazilian sockets. Even my consistent team for a Gainu isn't super consistent. But hey, back on Japan, we can use a Gainu versus a Gainu and it'll be 100% consistent, cause who needs any other 6-star but strength teams versus strength teams? Where's my Namuel? Do I not have a Namuel? Have I not favored a Namuel? Favorite one. Power up. Yep, I haven't favored Namuel yet. That's why. What's my consistent team? Double Whitebeard. It's gonna be double Whitebeard with my Int Mihawk sub. Don't remember the rest. Probably double Whitebeard, Aokiji, Int Mihawk sub, something, 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 something. The hard part with a double Whitebeard team is stage 3, whenever they do the captain swap. Stage 3 is gonna be a killer for many teams. That captain swap on stage 3, if you get bad cooldowns on that stage 3, you're just dead. I mean, the double Whitebeard team doesn't need Legend Mihawk. Like, you can do the double Whitebeard team without Legend Mihawk. And just swap Legend Mihawk for something to help you get through stage 3. Because stage 3, RIP. Enel definitely. Oh! Enel and Blue Vista for orb manipulation. I'm probably gonna be using Blue Dofi. Enel Blue Dofi. Would Fuji be more consistent? I don't have a Fuji myself, so I never use a Fuji team versus it. But Fuji's pretty much always good. Double 6-star Dofi. Yeah, even with a team that would 100% worth double 6-star Dofi, I would still probably put that as 3 out of 4 for just fucking balling. Just balling it up. Just choking with double 6-star Dofi. Because that's super fun, choking with 6-star Dofi. It's my favorite thing to do. Just choking. Yep, wish we had Colosseum Vista. Colosseum Vista would be really nice for the free-to-play team. You'll get your summons during Sugo. Can you beat with Rayleigh? Let's just go no. The Facebook group, send them PayPal in your account and they'll give you free gems on it. Give you gems on it? Yeah. You know, I'm not saying that it's a good deal. If you send them money and your account, it's a good deal for somebody. It's quite the steal if you send them money and give them your account information. Quite the steal. Rayleigh is great for the damage, but you kind of need the specials from it. Rayleigh doesn't bring in good enough special to go against a Kainu. Is that it? You know what? You can be used as a socket and a skill up because you're worthless anyways. One more. Yeah, the Rayleigh 6 plus, I would expect Rayleigh 6 plus to be next. Because of all the lower end 6-star characters, Rayleigh is the last lower end 6-star character. All the other ones have gotten a bit of a boost except for Rayleigh. Just waiting on that, Rayleigh. Come on, Rayleigh. Be the monster I know you are. How am I? I'm doing great. I'll kill it. Did someone steal the kid's account? He said that he deleted his tweet and issued a new password, so it sounds like he no one took his account. But, you know, I'm sure we gave him the scare well enough for him to not give away his account information in hopes that someone just buys some gems. Kobe, go away with Kobe, I guess, since you're not worth points. Kobe's for Kobe's, man. Ba-da-ba, 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 ba-da-ba. What day are we gonna do the Sugo stream? Whenever Sugo comes out. Yeah, useless. How many turns you can safely stall for a Kainu? Zero, because you're never safe versus a Kainu raid. Nothing's safe versus a Kainu. Okay, that's it for skill ups. Nothing like clearing up 500 box space for skill ups. We got extra. I've got all these characters, the These ones I'll probably get a copy of during Sugo. I mean, those... Actually, I guess... Oh, they have 5-star versions. We can get them during Sugo. We can definitely get them during Sugo. And then we'll just get a bunch of 6-stars. We'll just get a bunch of 6-stars. Guys, those are my skill-ups. Get your Rayleigh points. Remember, if you're getting the Rayleigh points from the bazaar, I would recommend saving for the ships. Those good, good ships. But I... gonna buy myself an oars. Because I can. Because I got the money. Never actually even use them. But we got one. I've been Zeenigami. Thank you so much for watching. Good luck with your skill ups. Hope they're a little better than mine. Oh yeah! We're not done because... Global has friend point turtles going on. So we're gonna... That's why we're cleaning out box space. So we can fill it up with more turtles. And... plenty of people have tweeted out that you can get princess turtles. So fingers crisscrossed. No story mode characters, but we got turtles. Because what I need on Global are more levels, right? Really, really need those levels, man. I actually wouldn't mind turtles on Japan, but... not everyone can get a job. Like I said, if you don't have a job, don't move out. You can start a GoFundMe page and go on the internet and beg people for money. I'm never gonna give you money, and I will think less of people who make GoFundMe pages to do stuff that they want to do because they don't have enough money and don't have a job to do it. Go get a job. You want money? Go get a job. I understand if it's like, ugh, this terrible emergency happened. I got into an accident. Help fund me to pay for my medical bills. Yeah, I understand that. Perfectly reasonable. Go fund me because I don't have money. And I want to do this thing. But I don't need to. Nah. Go get a job. I mean... which by the way, go to patreon.com/Zeenigami and subscribe. Or you can type in exclamation mark donate to give me money on Twitch. Let's do a little bit of that. Guys, I really, really want to get this yacht, and it's just not happening right now, and so. If you go to patreon.com/Zeenigami and subscribe on there, you can really help me get that yacht. The difference is I'm offering you something, because I'll make videos of me on that yacht, and then you guys get to enjoy watching me enjoy my yacht. You get to enjoy me making YouTube videos on my yacht. I can stream from my yacht. Isn't that great? I'll be able, instead of having this background, you'll be able to see the ocean behind me. But then of course I'm gonna have to like buy a better camera, or else the light's gonna be all messed up. So I'll have to buy a new camera, and I'll have to, we'll have to like get really, really good Wi-Fi so I can, or satellite so I can stream from my yacht while I'm out in the middle of the ocean. So that's really important. So, you know, there's a lot of things you have to think about whenever you want to buy a yacht. Like, a lot of people don't realize, like, man, now I gotta buy good satellite internet for my yacht. And I gotta hire people to work on my yacht. And I gotta hire people to clean my yacht. And there's just things that people don't think about. Like, Jesus, man. See, I'm smart enough to know that when I get my yacht, I'm gonna have to hire some slaves. I mean, workers, to help me take care of my yacht. And, you know, normally I go the Chinese kid route and just, like, hire a bunch of Chinese kids to work on my yacht, but people might notice because yachts are like out in the middle of the water, and that's a lot harder. Those kids, they can swim really well, and you know, if you don't keep them chained up, they were just like, they're out of there. You think you're like, oh yeah, we're like 5 miles off the shore, there's no way they're gonna escape, and those kids are just like gone, and you're like, oh well, now I gotta go find some more Chinese kids to help work on my yacht, and it's just terrible. And that's just my 50 cents. 50 cent. We're not gonna get a golden yacht. Who do you think I am? Jeez. 15 more pulls. So yeah, guys, please donate for my yacht. It's just, I really need money for my yacht. Can I get one princess turtle? One princess turtle? I got 5 more pulls after this to get a princess. Oh yeah, golden cap check. We don't have golden cap today. 4 out of 5. 1, 2, 3. Dang, no princesses. Alright, no princesses. And what is my total elders? 115. We already opened the mail. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 19. No, that one doesn't count. That's not dream pulls. 18 out of 115 elders. No princesses. Yeah, guys, I've been Zeenigami. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this, you can go to patreon.com and help me buy a yacht. Or you can go to twitch.tv/Zeenigami and watch me on there, where I will remind you that I'm a sellout and I really, really want to get that yacht and hookers to go on that yacht and cocaine to do on the yacht and people to work on the yacht and gas for the yacht. I mean, like, we don't really need gas for the yacht. At some point, we can just throw a big-ass sail on the yacht. I mean, it's a boat, right? The yacht's just like a big boat, so we can just put a sail on it, so that's gonna be fine. But yeah, help me, go to youtube.com/Zeenigami. You're on youtube.com/Zeenigami. Shit. Thank you so much for watching, and y'all stay beautiful.